I'm your host, Theophilus McPherson, and I know Drake have a video out called God's Plan. But my friend, God's plan is according to Matthew 6:33, and it says, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." And it's amazing that we are going for the carriage and not going after the horse. We got to go after the horse first, then the carriage. What I'm saying, when Jesus Christ said that, "Seek ye first the kingdom," God wants you to get born again. And it's amazing that when people get saved, the first thing they want is things rather than him. My friend, I'm telling you from the sincerity of my heart, the first thing you get to do is to get salvation. Because if you get salvation, you won't get lost into things. Because things can change your mind. Things can change your concern. Things can change your dedication toward God. The Bible say, glory to God, "The blessing of the Lord make you rich and had no sorrow with it." And it's amazing in our society, people are going after blessing and not going after the blesser. And the blesser is Jesus Christ. A lot of people going after the healing, but they're not going after the healer, which is Jesus Christ. My friend, when the book of Proverbs say, "The blessing of the Lord make you rich and add no sorrow to it." So Drake's method of God's plan is monetary. My friend, God's plan is not monetary. Even though he say that, glory to God, hallelujah, no good thing will he withhold of them that walk uprightly before him. So when Jesus Christ tell him, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." Jesus Christ say, "Is those that have forsaken houses and land and all these things, glory to God, and I will give you this world, glory to God. I will give it to you, oh, glory to God." And how the rich young ruler, when he say that, "I kept all the commandments, I did all this," but Jesus Christ say, "Go sell what you have and give to the poor, and you shall have treasure in heaven." And the Bible say, the rich young ruler walked away sad. And a lot of people, they walking away sad because when it comes to salvation, they think it's about sensation. It's not about salvation. But salvation is better than sensation. Because money, my friend, I'm going to tell you what money can buy. Money can buy you life insurance, but money can't buy you life. Money can buy you sex, but money can't buy you love. Money can buy you glasses, but money can't buy you vision. Money, glory to God, can buy you all these pretty things, my friend. But money, my friend, it can buy you life insurance, but it can't buy you eternal life. It can buy you a nice home, a nice house, but it can't buy you a nice home, because Jesus Christ told his disciples, "Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it was not so, I go prepare a place for you. Where I am, he may be also." So God's plan is for your life is to be saved, is to be born again. And it's amazing that how Nicodemus came to Jesus Christ by night. He came to Jesus Christ by secret, my friend. He was a secret disciple. He came to Jesus Christ by night and said, "Master, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. Can no man can do this miracle that thou doest except God be with him?" And Jesus Christ said unto him, "Verily, verily, I sent thee, except a man be born," glory to God, "again, he can't see the kingdom of God." And Jesus Christ, and Nicodemus say, "How can a man be born? Shall he enter into a second time in his mother womb and be born?" But Jesus Christ saying, "Verily, verily, I send thee, except a man be born of the water and of the Spirit, he shall not enter into the kingdom of God. And Jesus Christ said, marvel that I said thee, you must be born again. The wind bloweth, and thou hear the sound thereof, and know where it cometh and where it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. That was his flesh is flesh, that was the Spirit of Spirit. Marvel that I said unto thee, you must be born again. I'm telling you, my friend, seek ye first the kingdom and his righteousness, and all the houses, all the cars will be added unto you. But we must seek the kingdom. The Bible says, my friend, no homosexual, no liars, no adulterers shall inherit the kingdom of God. But such was some of us, but we are washed, we are justified, and we are sanctified. So God's plan is for you to be saved. God's plan is for you to be born again. God's plan is for us to know him, my friend. Because a lot of people heard about him, but they don't know him. It's amazing. You got a lot of people hear about Jesus. The lady that was at the well, when she had an encounter with Jesus Christ, and she went to the city and told them about a man. But the men at the city say that we don't believe him, but we heard him for ourselves. And you, as being a believer, you gotta know him for yourself. Glory to God. Don't let nobody tell you about him. You gotta experience him for yourself. So God's plan is not about money, my friend. Come money, my friend, hallelujah, the Bible said love of money is the root of all evil. So if you think that the video about Drake is about God's plan is about money, my friend, money can't fix your problem. But I come and tell you, oh, glory to God, that Jesus, he can fix your problem. God can fix your problem. Oh, God. Oh, hallelujah. Because I'm telling you, a lot of people, my friend, they die without Jesus. They have all the money in the world, and money cannot rescue them. Money cannot save them. Money can, glory to God, it can buy you the best medicine. Though you're rich, my friend, hallelujah, but I'm coming to tell you that money gonna perish away. Money gonna, the Bible say that they that are rich have wings and fly away. But I'm telling you that to know him, hallelujah, and to experience him, and to experience him, you got to be born again. You got to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. You got to be, have your name on the roll, my friend. Is your name on the roll? I know you're rich, my friend. I know you got money. I know you're rich for your IRA. I know you got CDs in the bank. But I'm asking you, I'm telling you, are you born again? Are you transformed by renewing of your mind? Do you have a relationship with Jesus Christ? Because Jesus Christ, hallelujah, is a person. And to be a Christian, you gotta have a personal relationship, not with a church, not with a pastor, not with your saints of God, but with Jesus Christ. And a lot of people, they go to church but don't have no relationship with Jesus Christ. Oh, glory to God. I come to tell you, if you have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, you can call him any time of the hour. You ain't got to worry about calling the pastor, because a pastor might be asleep. But I come to tell you, the Bible says, they that labor are labor in vain. They watch the city, but they labor in vain that watch the city. I come to tell you, we got to have a personal relationship with the person, and the person is Jesus Christ. I'm not religious. I'm not glory to God of religion, because religion is a system made by man to control you. But James say in James chapter 1:26, if any man seem to be religious and bridle not his tongue, this man religion is in vain. But to be religious, glory to God, you must, my friend, be not entangled with the world, but being spotted from the world, but to visit the fatherless and the orphanage, my friend. So I'm telling you, God's plan is for you to be saved. God's plan is for you to be sanctified. God's plan is for you to be justified. God's plan for you to be filled with the Holy Ghost, not being thrilled, but being filled. Being filled means you let the Holy Ghost lead you and guide you into all truth. And we If we have God's plan, we are born again. If we have God's plan, we know the A, B, C, the A, we acknowledge him, we accept him, and the B, we, hallelujah, we've been bought with a price, hallelujah, and the price is the blood of Jesus Christ, and we got the C, we confess him, we are concerned, hallelujah, of our soul, and we, D, we are delivered. So the A, B, C, D, oh, glory to God. So I'm telling you, God's plan is for you to be saved. God's plan is for you, your name to be written on the scroll, my friend. Because, hallelujah, if you stand before God, what are you going to say to God? You can't say your mama hinder you. You can't say your daddy hinder you. You can't say the pastor hinder you. You can't say the church hinder you. But God going to say, why should I let you into my kingdom? And what you gonna say? You're gonna be speechless. But I'm preparing you, my friend. You must acknowledge him. You must confess him that he's Lord of your life. He's Lord of your soul. What must I do to be saved? You must repent, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, for the promise unto you and to your children, as many the Lord have called. So you must repent. You must have a heart. Say, Lord, I'm sorry that I sinned against you, and repent of your sin and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sin, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Oh, God. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. What is the Holy Ghost? I'm so glad you asked. The Holy Ghost is the person. The Holy Ghost is a character. Oh, not to be in character, but to have the non-fruit of the Spirit. Is your fruit have the if your body have the fruit of the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, goodness, gentleness. Without such, there is no law. So I'm telling you, God's plan is for you to be saved. Not for you to have money. Not for you to have all these sensational things. Oh, glory. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. So God's plan is for you to be saved. Yes, my friend, is you to be saved. Are you saved today? If you are to close your eyes and wake up, where are you going to wake up in? Are you going to wake up in hell? Or are you going to wake up into heaven? Heaven. God is waiting for you. So I'm telling you, hallelujah, God's plan is for you to be saved.